Elizabeth Chong. Of course, she's a national treasure.
Guess who's back today? Mel's back. Do you know Mel? She is the best looking.
Stagehand
in Australian television or theatre. It's lovely to have her back.
I met her down at makeup and I said, oh, you've got yourself away from the desk. And she said, yeah, I'm going to take over Nerys Block. Is that what we're talking about?
No.
Oh.
Sorry. You just went off the tangent. This is Mel, who's a lovely stagehand on the show.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah. I was just wondering why the stagehands would be going into makeup.
I know what it is.
Nerys is like, she's having the baby.
That's right. Yeah. And who is going to take over Nerys?
Meredith. Who's usually at the switchboard and she's taking over, looking after the artists
there.
And Mel is moving the scenery. Yeah. So it's
Meredith.
It's great. Welcome back, Mel, anyway. Mel. Lovely to have you here. And I apologise for Elizabeth. She's not
sorry.
Very well. That's okay.
Oh, that's so funny. I'd rather hear about Mel myself, actually. But she was a celebrity chef long before the term was even conceived. A pioneer in promoting Chinese cooking.
Yeah. She entered our lives in the 90s, thanks to Bert Newton and Good Morning Australia. Our excuse to entice her back to 10 is Lunar New Year. We're scooting in on the tail end of the tiger. We're delighted that Elizabeth and her daughter Angie are joining us from Elizabeth's home in Melbourne. What a treat to speak to you guys this morning. Did you celebrate the occasion yesterday?
Well, we certainly did, yes.
Yes, well, Chinese New Year to all of Chinese, no matter whether they live in China or abroad anywhere, is one of the most important festivals of all. It's kind of everything wrapped up in one, and on that day, everybody tries to see every member of the family. And we just celebrate with a lot of noise, a lot of happiness, a lot of colour, and, of course, a lot of food.
Elizabeth and Angie, it is such a pleasure having you with us this morning. Are there any specific traditions relating specifically to the Year of the Tiger?
Oh, there are so many traditions, probably a lot of them lost these days, particularly with Aussie Chinese. But in the olden days, people used to take it very seriously. They would travel thousands of miles to be with each other, and housewives would make sure that every bit of dust in the household is swept out and the house is bright and clean. Everybody has new clothes. Nobody gets their hair cut. They don't even cook on New Year's Day because that's kind of cutting luck. So, and all debts have to be paid, by golly. That's most important. Some people go into hiding when they debt because people just say you've just got to settle all your debts and have a clean slate for the new year. So altogether, it's a really fresh start for the new year. Let's hope that's going to happen for all of us here in Australia.
Mm. Yep. So dumplings are a big part of it. And Angie, I understand you're a bit of a dumpling whiz. Was there... I actually ate 8 last night because 8 is a lucky number, so I had 8 dumplings. Hope that was a good move.
Yes.
Was there ever any doubt that you'd be following in your mum's footsteps?
Oh, I did actually try not to follow in my mother's footsteps, but I'm afraid that the genes must run very deep, very strong. So as much as I tried not to do food, I ended up doing it. Yeah, absolutely. And dumplings was where I finished up. Yeah.
I do the traditional foods and Angie does a little bit more of the modern stuff.
Right.
So here, we've got a little bit to show.
Great.
Probably the main thing, I think, well, we can show dumplings later if we have time.
Let's do it. Yeah, do it now. What is the secret to making the perfect dumpling?
We've got a very...
The secret to making the perfect dumpling.
Okay.
I think that the secret to making the perfect dumpling is to share it with your loved ones, whether it's family or friends. Because everybody wants to eat a lot of dumplings, you need to have a lot of people to help. So
and families do them together, don't they? They
absolutely.
Make them together.
It's very much a shared activity.
Yeah.
Oh, great. Speaking of secrets, this isn't a secret anymore. Your grandfather, Elizabeth, your father, created the dim sim.
Yeah, well, that's a real special dumpling. That's a really Aussie Chinese dumpling, and have we embraced that? So he's a bit of an icon within the food industry. But there's a family dish that we call Yu Xiang. It's a pretty new one, but we love it, and we're going to have it together tonight.
Tonight.
And it involves fresh fish, which the name for fish is ewe, which means prosperity and more than enough. And so you have fresh fish, you have beautiful ingredients. I've got some on the table here. We've got a pomelo, which is wonderful, wonderful part of it. And then we have colourful fruits like red apples, and we have a Chinese daikon, which is a Chinese radish, carrots, cucumber,
lettuce,
peanuts, lettuce. We've got ginger, sesame seeds, and a beautiful plum sauce. Oh, and over the crispy to give it texture, we've got some crisp. These are actually wonton skins, which we shredded and we deep fried, sprinkled over the top. And everybody who sits at the table gets a little red envelope with spices in it. And we all sprinkle the spices over before we eat with a pair of chopsticks. We lift all these ingredients, which we've turned into a beautiful sort of a salad, mound of salad. We toss and toss and mix it together, family together. The higher you toss, the higher the luck.
Wow. And the secret ingredient for this one is this homemade sauce, the homemade salad dressing.
Yeah.
Is that like is that a well-kept secret, like, you know, on a Big Mac?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. I think every family has their own secret recipe for this special salad. It's only ever prepared for New Year.
Oh, Elizabeth and Angie, I love the sound of all of those beautiful traditions. And can I just ask, is all of that done around a round table, specifically sitting at a round table and the significance of it being round?
Yeah, from a practical point of view, Angela, sitting around a round table is so easy because within chopstick reach, everybody can reach every dish. There's very little passing around. We all dive in all over the table. But the roundness does represent the complete circle of happiness and togetherness, and the family really feel together because we share the food, we share the joy, and we share the good luck together.
Wow. I wish you were in Sydney right now.
You can smell it down the screen, can't you?
Yeah, I just want to eat that food, but I'm going to settle for the Chico roll, which also plays a huge part. Commercialise the Chico roll.
Oh. We don't like talking about the Chico roll. We like talking about the Wing Lee. The Wing Lee, the original chicken roll. Actually, chicken rolls are originally called spring rolls, and they're always eaten at Chinese New Year. They had to herald spring. So we should be eating spring rolls as well at this time. Yes, my dad, William Wing Young, he kind of invented the Australian takeaway dim sim and the chicken roll for the Australian public, particularly Victorians. And I'm just really very proud of his contribution to the Australian Chinese food scene.
Amazing. Your contribution is incredible too, Elizabeth. And you've written a long-awaited autobiography. Have you got a couple of teasers and when can we get our hands on it?
I'm very happy and rather surprised to say that I have finished the first draft, which has come to more than 60,000 words so far.
Wow.
It embraces my whole life from the time I arrived from China when I was a little girl of three right to today. So it is a glimpse, well, I suppose it's sort of just letting people into my whole life, my whole journey of being, a migrant from the very early days, one of the first migrants, I suppose. Can I go back to 1934 and how I grew up in the community and how I became a real Australian as well through the medium of my beloved food and my family.
Oh, Elizabeth.
And all my children, actually, grandchildren, now great-grandchildren. We now are six generations of Australians, of Chinese living in Australia, which is rather, we're very proud of that.
You are, we are amongst royalty right now, that's in other words.
So maybe this book may be published mid-year next year.
Great.
And just finally, we started, Elizabeth, when we introduced you by showing some of your golden moments with Bert Newton. What were those days like?
What golden moments?
What were your golden moments?
I would say that every session I had with Bert was a joy. He always hugged me and welcomed me every time I came into the studio. And I think he always had a little bit of a twinkle in his eye. He remembered early days. He knew my father. He had met my father in his restaurant, the Golden Phoenix. And I think he had a spot, a special spot for Chinese cuisine and me. And he used to whisper, you know, nice things to me. And I always felt that I was not just a presenter with him, I was his friend as well. Mm. And Bert was like that with everybody, though. He really gave of himself to you because he was such an experienced person. But he loved, I suppose, the golden moments were when he used to actually be mischievous and try to trick me up. All the time when I was cooking. I would present a chicken, you know, and he'd say, well, what would I do if there was a three-legged chicken, Elizabeth, you know? Try to distract me from cooking. And sometimes he succeeded, but very often I was able to kind of absorb it, and then we'd both laugh about it, you know. So, yes, good. Our lovely memories with Bert always. And I will always remember him with great affection and gratitude, because he kind of launched me into perhaps a national public. It was before I was sort of known more in Melbourne, but with Good Morning Australia, which of course was national, and I was there for 12 years, once or twice a week, so I was a part of people's homes for all that time.
Well, we are full of gratitude for you being part of our studio and our homes today. Thank you so much, Elizabeth and Angie, for joining us this morning on Studio 10. And happy Lunar New Year.
Thank you. And the same to you. The same to everybody. Kung Yi Fa Choi.